Now we will learn how to record transactions where the owner makes a cash investment or a cash withdrawal. These types of transactions are when the owner commingles the business funds with his or her personal funds. Investment means the owner deposits money into the business bank account from a non-business bank account. Very simply put, the owner puts money into the business. On the other side, withdrawals means the owner takes money from the business bank account for a non-business reason. Simply put, the owner takes money out of the business. When we record either of these two transactions, we have to have an account in the chart of accounts to record them in. For a transaction that is an investment, we have to have an account in the chart of accounts called capital. The type of account this is equity. When we record money being taken out of the company, we have to have an account in the chart of accounts called withdrawals. That's the name that we're going to give the account, and the account type again is equity. You should probably study the first two or three chapters of Introduction to Accounting to understand what the word equity means in this context and to learn about these two accounts. But from the bookkeeper's point of view, just use these accounts when we record the transaction. From the main menu, click List, Chart of Accounts. In the bottom left, click Account, New. When the new account window opens up, choose equity as the account type. You can read about equity type of accounts over here in this field. We click Continue and leave the account type chosen as equity. Then type in the word Holden's Capital. Then click Save and New. The account type equity is still in the account type, and we type the next account, Holden's Withdrawals. Then we click Save and Close. Now we have the two accounts in the chart of accounts that we need to record the owner investing or withdrawing cash to or from the company bank account. Now let's imagine on April 9, Holden wrote check number 205 from the company bank account to Verizon for fixing his child's phone. Clearly, this was a check for non-business reasons. Therefore, the account that records this check is not telephone expense. The account that records this check is withdrawals. Just for good practice, let's record this check in the register window. From the main menu, click Banking, Use Register. Then in the Use Register pop-up, click OK. Now we open the cash and bank account in the register window. At the bottom of the register window, we will record this new check. Click the calendar box and go back to April 9 and put the date of this check. Click in the number field and hope that QuickBooks remembers we're up to check 205. If 205 did not automatically come up on your screen, remove what's there and put check number 205. Now, when we click the payee, we choose Verizon. But look what happens when we click on the name Verizon. QuickBooks automatically puts telephone expense as the account for this check. We must change this to Holden's withdrawals. This is not telephone expense for the company. This is a personal expense for Holden. It does not count as a company expense. So we put Holden's withdrawals. The payment amount is $1,000 and we push tab. Now, at the bottom of your register window, click record. Notice the balance of the bank account went down. But if we open the trial balance, you can see that for the very first time, Holden's withdrawals showed up on the trial balance for $1,000, the amount of this check. Now, what about this transaction? On April 10, Holden took an ATM cash withdrawal from the company bank account to repair the foundation of his house, $2,000. The ATM slip had the number 9876543 as the unique transaction identification number. This is obviously not for business, and therefore we will again use the withdrawals account. Let's record this one in the Write a Checks window. From the main menu, click Banking, Write a Check. The date of this transaction is April 10, and because this is not really a check, we don't want a check number here. We want the unique transaction identification number. In this case, it was on the ATM slip, number 9876543. Now, we put the money amount as $2,000, and as discussed, we go down to the bottom and we put the account as Holden's withdrawals. Now, we're almost finished. You could leave the payee field blank, but instead, it would be better to click the pull-down list, and you could add Holden's name on the fly, which means you add the name at the minute you record the transaction. So let's click Add New and tell QuickBooks Holden is not a vendor, customer, or employee. Click Other and we will put the owner's name on the other name list. Click OK and just type in his first name in this case, Holden. Then click OK. Again, you could leave it blank, but it's nice to put the owner's name on the other name list. When we click Save and Close, we can open the trial balance and see that Holden's withdrawals has now increased to $3,000. By the way, the other name list is located here, List, Other Name List. Only Holden's name is currently on this list. But this would be the list of names that you would have for anyone who is not a customer, vendor, or employee. Now let's look at two investment transactions. First, on April 11, Holden took cash from his personal savings and put it into the company bank account, $2,000, and the deposit slip was number 3691215. Let's record this in the register window. From the main menu, click Banking, Use Register, then click OK. The register window opens up, and at the bottom of the register window, we record the transaction and we first put the date, April 11th. The deposit slip number is 3691215. Now, there is no payee, and you could leave this field blank, but it's nice to put in the owner's name so that you know who's responsible for this transaction. In this case, he is investing money into the business, so the account we choose is Holden's Capital. We put the money amount in the deposit column, and we type in 2000 and push tab. Now we have all the information we need for this deposit. We click record, and if we bring forward the trial balance, we now notice that Holden's Capital shows up on the trial balance for the first time as $2,000. If we look again at the bottom of the register, to the transaction that we already recorded, we can double click here on the word deposit and we can see that this is the way the transaction would look if we recorded it into this window, the make deposits window. So you could open up this window, put in Holden's Capital, put in $2,000. In the memo field, you could put the deposit slip number if you wanted to, and this exact transaction could have been recorded here, and then when we open the register window, we would have seen it looks the same here. Let's do one more investment just to see how this would work. Let's imagine on April 12, Holden took more cash from his personal savings and put it into the company bank account, this time $5,000. Deposit slip number 61718191. This is not from customers, and therefore we will use the capital account. From the main menu, click Banking, Make Deposit. Notice the payment window opens in front of the deposit window, and in this case, we can just close it out. So we put the date of the deposit, which is April 12th, received from Holden, and the account is Holden's Capital. Holden's Capital. And of course, put the payment amount of $5,000. That's it. That's all you have to do. Click Save and Close, and when we open the trial balance, we can see Holden's capital has increased to $7,000. If you look at the bottom of the register window, you can see that both of these transactions look the same in the register window. And when we click the word deposit, we go back to the window that we just had open to record this deposit.